Welcome to Coral Rocks, and I do mean rocks, because my guest this week is the guy that puts the rocks in Coral Rocks for sure. I got the one and only Brent Derner sitting across from me, from my wicked twin, and we're going to spend the next hour talking about all kinds of stuff and playing My Wicked Twin and some of Brent's favorite songs, so stay tuned and enjoy the ride. Hi, Brent.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, Coral.
How are you?
I'm beside myself. I should be a twin.
Yeah. I can't remember. I don't know. I can't remember the last time I saw you. It's been a while. That's for sure.
It's been like probably 5 or 10 years.
Yeah, I would say. So we're going to, because it was Robbie Burns Day the other day, which is like a Scottish festival. And a couple of people have emailed me and asked me to play this band. So I got to play it for Tellys. They're a really cool Scottish band called Chelsea Dagger. And then we're going to come back and we're going to play the first My Wicked Twin song. And it has quite a story behind it, too. This is Coral Rocks, 98.5 CKWR. CKWR is for Tellys and Chelsea Dagger. And that goes out to my friend Kieran and the gentleman that wrote to me the other day and asked me to play the Fratellis. He said it was a great Scottish band. TJ, I think that is. So it's 9:34 here on Coral Rocks. So we got Brent Derner in the studio. And Brent, you know what? Let's go way back. Like, I met you when I was a kid, really. So how did you, why music? What got you into music? Why music?
I think we got a Deep Purple album for Christmas, Machine Head, and that just, my ears and brain were blown away by the musicianship. And, you know, my twin brother was drumming.
Yeah.
And he had, I think we were like 12, and he had a drum kit, and we were both drumming on him, but because they were his kit, he'd go, I was getting good on the drums. He said, they're my drums, get off of them. I had to get off of them. They were mine. So I just asked for a guitar for Christmas because I couldn't stay on the drums. And I got a guitar for Christmas, and that was it. And then, you know.
Oh, yeah. Oh, man.
It was, you know, my brother Tom, he played the bass. My dad and my other brother Larry played the clarinet. I think one of my other brothers played a trombone or a trumpet. So that's kind of where it came from.
Wow. You should write a book. Like, we were talking off the air. So how many times do you figure you've traveled around the world? There's got to be, like, probably have seen the whole.
Well, we did 13 countries on the KISS tour, on the KISS Lick It Up tour, in Trinidad and Tobago. So 15 countries, and then, of course, America and Canada.
Yeah, exactly. So you should write a book.
You got to be about the 12th person that said that.
Brent, you really should write a book, honest to God. I can't, like, I'm telling every musician I know, write a book, because you guys have the stories behind the stories, and that's what people love to hear.
Well, they might not like what I have to hear, or what I'd have to say.
Not all of them, but
you
know.
Should, sometimes I would recommend that sometimes you not meet your idol.
Yeah.
I'd have to say that.
Oh, okay, is there somebody
like
you...
Like a lunch bag letdown sometimes.
Is there somebody you've met that...
Oh, yeah. I don't know what I should say. I could maybe put it in a book.
Yeah, put it in a book. You can tell me off the air. So the first song we're going to... My Wicked Twin has been around for a while. That's mostly you and Brian, right? But you have, like, your brother Brian Derner. So you guys have worked with lots of different people as well over the years.
Yeah.
Including my pal Hills from Fog. He's been a guest in the studio a couple of times, and also Peter Beacock, which is amazing.
Yeah, Hills was jamming at my place a couple houses ago, and he was just vocal jamming. He is so good at that.
Oh yeah,
and he was just singing non-words and scatting. And that song ended up being, I gave him 50% songwriting credit for the song The White Parts of Her Tan.
Oh, great, because we're going to play that. Like, we've got some of your favorites as well, but we're going to start off with iGiant, because this is one heck of a video.
Can I say something about that?
Yes.
Do you know, we were always taught with Capitol Records, with our international record deal,
yeah,
that we always had to have a chorus, right? That's like your advertisement of the song.
Yeah.
It's like one of the first songs I've ever written, this iGiant, that doesn't have a chorus. It doesn't. Nowhere does it sing iGiant.
Nope, doesn't say iGiant anywhere.
No.
You got to check out the video. But we're gonna talk about this song. This is how you ended up being a guest, I think. I just said, okay, what? Well, we're just going to play the song. What the hell? We're just going to play the song, and we'll come back. This is Coral Rocks, my very special guest, Brent Derner.
Seven o'clock, a cannonball. and I push to the side, turning and loving them, letting it slide. Deep apple from my smell, the blood of the English. Stomp of the beast, carry them all, shaking my head and I'm ready to fall. Deep apple from my smell, the blood of an English.
That is iGiant, and that is My Wicked Twin, and my very special guest in the studio is Brent Derner. So, Brent, tell me about this song. Like, why did you write this song, and tell me a little bit about the background of this song.
Not really sure how these ideas come to me. I always, for songwriting, pick my song title first, and I always tried to write the song chorus first.
Yeah.
And then you write the rest of the song. That's my take on how I do that. I'm not sure how I even came up with it. I'm not sure. There's other songs that I wrote, like on the new album. I've got a song called A Noon Walk on the Asylum Lawn.
Okay.
And there's a lot of piano in that. How? I actually look back on my own songs and go, how did I even come up with this? I can't really answer you. It just comes to me, man.
Yeah, that's fair enough. That is fair enough. So what song would you like to play next? Do you want to play...
I like, what I'd like to say about the songwriting, you know, if you can write lyrics that paint pictures, rather than saying, I gave my girlfriend a flower, you want to say, I gave my sexy girl a ruby red rose.
Yeah.
The latter is the better lyrics, because you can paint images. So,
that's right.
So I try to pick great song titles that I keep a running list on, and one song title was The White Parts of Her Tan.
Well, we can play that next.
What don't you understand about that imagery?
You haven't changed at all.
I can tell you how I got that, though.
Okay.
A guy came to me in the bar and said, hey, what's the best parts about a tan? I go, I don't know. He goes, the white parts. And I always remembered that joke, and I wrote, that's how I got the title. It was from a joke.
We're going to play the white parts of her tan. Hold on a second here. And then I want to go back to, iGiant. Just before we play White Parts of Her Tan, that's done with AI, right? Like, what?
The video, yeah.
Yeah, the video. So, how did you do that? And who's on the song? Like, how did you put the song together? Because this is cool, too.
Well, you know, I guess I'm kind of like a one-man band with a whole bunch of guests at this point. The drummer is Steve Gadd. When you get addictive drums, you get Steve Gadd, the world's most recorded drummer, or one of them. It's programmable software, right? But you get Steve Gadd's drum patterns, and you can see that it's not like a locked-in clock. He plays ahead of the beat, and he plays behind the beat, and like real drummers do. And I played the track for some of my expert drummer friends, and they even went, "Wow, what the heck is going? Who played that drum track?" I said, "Steve Gadd did." They go, "How did you get him?" I said, "You get Steve Gadd with Addictive Drums."
That is so cool. And the video itself is, I mean, I was at Tricon last weekend, which was the ultimate geek fest. And that video, like, splashed across the top of the museum would have been perfect because it's all done in AI and it looks like something out of a superhero movie or something like that.
That AI, it's... Like, AI is kind of stupid at times. Like, you can say, "I want a man walking down the street." You won't get that. Just stupid.
What do you get?
A guy standing there and a whole bunch of other stuff moving.
Yeah.
You can't, you know, and it's got, of course, it's censored where you can't use dirty words.
No.
You can't use any hate words.
Yeah.
You can't use any violence or anything like that because the AI won't allow it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, which is a good thing.
Yeah, that makes sense.
So, I found that working in AI, I wasted all kinds of time and money because I figured I could type in a rock band, a four-piece rock band playing on stage.
Right.
And hit and tell it how long. You say 3.5-minute song, right?
Yeah.
Well, for the first 10 seconds, you'll get a band on stage, and then you'll get Aztec temples and spaceships and flowers and soup, right? Right. So it doesn't work that way.
Soup?
It just doesn't work that way.
Yeah.
So I learned after probably wasting a bunch of money and time that now when I work in AI, I render for only 8 or 10 seconds at a time, and you'll get what you want.
Okay.
Yeah.
You should be a teacher, Brent. You'd be perfect at it. Okay, we're going to go back to the White Heart Surfer Tan. Yeah, it's a Saturday morning radio, Coral Rocks.
And Peter Beacock played piano on this.
Yes, Peter. Pete Fowler. Pete Fowler, I say hello if you're listening. Brent is here. Where are you? And also Peter Beacock.
Yeah, Pete, bring the beer.
Bring the beer. Bring the coffee. Okay, here's the White Parts of her Tan.
Sandals packed, drives a Sunbird sedan. She keeps the copper town close, but my favorite is all the white parts of a tan bikini. Land so teeny, write our names in the sand. Got a tattoo on her pumpkin, and her smile is really something. And our time is certainly at hand. The white parts of a tan. We'll be right back.
985 CKWR. That's the white parts of her tan. 950 here on Coral Rocks, and Brenter's in the studio with me. So that's another cool song. That's My Wicked Twin again. I like the guitars on that.
Thanks, man. I appreciate it.
I like the guitars on that. Okay, so we've got some of your other, like, there's a couple of songs that you sent to me that you, I want to play Brain Dance too. But there's a couple of other songs that you sent to me for your playlist.
Shine Down is one of them.
Shine Down. And who does that?
The band's called Shine Down.
Oh, okay. Okay, okay. I can find them.
I forget the song that I sent yet, but that guy's a good songwriter. I love the sound of his voice. Okay. One day when I grow up, I'll be able to sing like him, maybe, if I'm lucky.
People also search for Papa Roach. That's an interesting band as well. You sent me Papa Roach.
Yeah, that's a thing. These guys got great voices when they sing.
Yeah.
And they sound like men, and when I sing, I sound like a friggin' girl.
You do not. I don't think so. Like, I like the song Scars. That's a really cool song that you sent me, and this is quite the... it's got quite the story behind it, too, because I guess it's based on, you know, something that happened to him, which is kind of interesting. So we're gonna play Papa Roach, and we're gonna come back and talk about lyrics. Here's Papa Roach, Scars. This is one of the songs that Brent sent me.
Burn, I saw myself shut. My weakness is that I can't do much, and my scars remind me that the past is real. I tear my heart open just to fail. Drunk and I'm feeling down, and I just wanna be alone. I'm pissed 'cause you came around. Why don't you just go home? 'Cause I channeled all your pain, and I can't help you fix yourself. You're making me insane. All I can say is
yeah. 98.5 CKWR. That's Scars and Papa Roach. 9:56 here on Coral Rocks with my very special guest, Brent Derner. So we were talking off the air about songwriting. So what makes a good song? What makes a good song?
Well, you know, like I just finished saying, to pick a song like a song title like Let's Rock and Roll or Baby I Love You, that's tired and overdone, and those song titles likely won't fly anymore. They might have 30 or 40 years ago. I don't think too much now. So then you want to pick the best song title you can possibly find. My search never ends for good song titles. And so then you're going to grab that song title and you're going to sing it fast, slow, shuffle beat. And you're going to try to sing it six different ways and find you can use speech impediment rock if you want and sing that chorus title.
Right.
The one that has the best feel and feels good to you. And then how to get away from being pretentious at times. Like, this wouldn't apply to every song, but this is, you know, like if you're writing songs and your changes come at the end of every fourth bar, our educated listeners understand, oh, here comes the change. I can smell it coming.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
But say you go 3.5 bars and then write it to force yourself to not change at the standard place at the on the fourth bar every time. So you go 3.5 bars or 4.5 bars. Now all of a sudden your listener cannot really predict what's coming next, and that's a good thing in my eyes.
Yeah, that's very, very insightful, actually. I like there's an artist I really like, Jeff Buckley.
Yes.
Because of
his name.
His vocal octaves and the guitar is much different from a lot of stuff that you hear. So you're right, it stays with you.
Yeah, and then you can do, like, even iGiant, that's, I think it was 7/8, was it? So it cuts the end of the round off and repeats. So because it's cutting the end of the bar off, all of a sudden it's not as pretentious anymore.
Right, right. Okay, so we're going to play, what is this song? It's supposed to be No Good and Goodbye, but it's coming up, We Promise Something. So what is that?
I'm not really sure. I'd have to see when we're not chatting.
We're going to play it. We're here with Brent Derner from My Wicked Twin, and this is Lots of Fun on Coral Rocks. Here's more of My Wicked Twin. 98.5 CKWR. That's what we promised ourselves. And I've got special guest Brent Turner in the studio from My Wicked Twin.
Good morning.
And we'll be right back right after this. CKWR, House on the Highway. I got Brent Turner in the studio from My Wicked Twin. Brent, this song is a departure from what we've been listening to.
Yeah, you know, you don't always, like, just because, you know, I wished I was a rock guitar player, now I are one. You know what I mean? Instead, sometimes, say you just feel flippant and you want to write, but it's not a guitar rock song. Well, go ahead and write that song. So what? And so I've got a whole album of kind of pop songs that I'm going to release as a under a different artist when I can find a young, good-looking male singer to sing my pop album for me. So getting back to it is, like, don't pigeonhole yourself just because you're a rock guitar player. Write, if it feels good, go ahead and write it.
Yeah. Well, that was, there's banjo in that.
Yes, I did that. And I got mandolin on there too.
which is pretty cool. So why? Yeah, tell me a little bit about that song.
My brother Larry died. Saw all my old friends from Herbsville. We had a house on the highway on Herbsville Road.
Right.
Which is now Curbsville, really.
Yeah.
And, you know, used to work at the go-kart track, and a lot of those people are, the ones that haven't died, they're still all my friends after all these years, and, you know, friends have come and gone. I do what I can remembering them.
Yeah.
Remembering the teenage days, some sad. Those are the lyrics, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Getting smacked upside. I learned to live with, get a smacked upside the head. I learned to live with that. I'd be my old man, all right.
Yeah, you've always had ever since I met you, actually, I was kind of scared of you when I first met you. And, you're very streetwise, like very street.
Yeah.
I always thought that. And very driven and very passionate.
Well,
and,
thank you.
And you haven't changed. Not at all. So,
man, oh man, going through the bars in Canada back in those days, everybody wanted a fight. It was like we couldn't just go on stage and play.
Yeah.
Because in the middle of the song, you end up fighting with some arsehole, right?
Yeah. Oh, man.
That happened like 20 times, 20 different cities probably. All kinds of stuff like that.
Start writing a book. Here's another. This is another track that you sent me, Monster Truck. Why'd you send me this track? That's kind of cool.
That guy's got an awesome singing voice.
Yeah.
When I grow up, I'm going to have a singing voice like his.
Okay, we're going to play Monster Truck, Sweet Mountain River. This is Coral Box, my very special guest, Brent Derner. 98.5 CKWR. That's Monster Truck and Sweet Mountain River. So, Brent, why'd you pick that song? Because that's a cool song.
Because the guy's got a great voice, and I like guitar rock.
Well, that sounds like that's the Brent I know. Yep.
You know, you can play a million notes. People have heard all of that before already.
Yeah.
The guy kept his guitar solo simple. You know, the guy's kicking butt on the drums, and I dig it.
Yeah. Have we got, we played House on the Highway. Have we got another Wicked Twin song we can play?
I don't remember what I sent you.
You sent me House on the Highway. You sent me The White Parts of Her Tan. You sent me iGiant. Brain Dance. Oh, yes. This is a really cool, and again, this is a different sound.
This is my twin brother on drums, by the way, not a drum machine.
Yeah. This is very cool.
As a drummer, he's a cut above the rest, in my opinion.
Yeah, at one point, I remember he was with my brother. They had a band called All in One Breath. I used to follow those guys around. Remember that? Both of you. And it was, you know, so much fun for me. Actually, it's because of you guys. All of you guys that I got into this mess in the first place, like interviewing bands and hanging around with musicians and all of that stuff.
And your brother Phil was in All in One Breath, so I go to Guelph to see that band. We got in the worst friggin' fist fight between, they took a break, and we were punching the out of these guys in their dressing room. We ended up in a fight in their dressing room, for Christ's sakes.
With All in One Breath?
Yeah, in Guelph.
Oh, boy. Was that the Chooch, I'm thinking?
Yeah.
They used to play the Chooch all the time.
Major fist fight in the dressing room.
I don't know.
Some guys we don't know, right? Two guys we don't never seen before in our lives.
Oh, boy. But, yeah, I used to hang out, and my brother would be playing, and I would go, oh, this is really cool, you know. And then I started seeing bands, and I thought, well, I'm going to start. And I would sit there and watch you guys, and my head would be sideways watching how you guys, like, how Phil played the bass. And, you know, I remember when he was learning how to play guitar, because I was working at the Tulane restaurant all night long.
The
original Tulane restaurant. I'd come home, and Phil would be listening to Led Zeppelin for the 30th time. I'm like, Phil, I got to sleep. Well, I got to learn this song. I went, oh, man. So, you know, it was ingrained into me.
Well, the Led Zeppelin bassist, he wrote bass parts that challenged all bass players around the world. Went, wow.
Yeah, yeah. So, you know, it was Led Zeppelin, Jimi Hendrix, Jeff Beck, all that stuff he was listening to.
Yeah.
So it's all his fault. So, you know, I'm sending this show to Phil. So, he knows that we're... He knows you were going to be my guest. So this is, you know, so much fun. But we're going to play, tell me about Brain Dance, because again, this is another side of my Wicked Twin.
I just wanted to get a song written. I like the groove, and, you know, it's like a catch a note. I devote to bigger, better things. Lend me an ear, I'll give it back to you. It's just song. It's a song about writing songs and what goes on in your head to write a song.
Yeah, okay.
It's about, I guess. It's about nothing.
It's about nothing. That sounds like Seinfeld. And look how successful that was.
Yeah.
Yeah. This Brain Dance, my Wicked Twin. And who's on drums?
Brian Derner is on drums.
Well. 98.5 CKWR. That is My Wicked Twin and Brain Dance. So, Brian, your twin, is on drums. So, how do you and Brian work together? Because you guys have been, you know, doing stuff together for a long time, which is kind of neat.
Well, I mean, I don't know if somebody's got to write the song.
Yeah.
And everybody else kind of goes along with that, I suppose. not you can't have five guys try and write the song at the same time. You'll never get it written.
Yeah.
You know? So one or two guys do the writing and the other guys, sorry to say, just kind of play to it.
They play along with it.
Brian's a special drummer and he can surely spice up a tune just by his drum performances. I love double bass drum kick, double kick drums. Oh, yeah, baby, yeah.
Well, I like, you know what? I like the guitar riff in there, too. So how do you create that? I think a Queen when I hear that.
So did I.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I studied the Brian May guitar choir, and he'll put like five different solos on there that all are in harmony with each other.
Yeah.
And it's actually pretty simple. I mean, whatever the chord is, say it might be a D minor, so you play your solo in all the separate notes, the fifths, the octaves, the sevenths, or whatever it might be, and work it out. So you're basically playing chords one note at a time on a different track. So I want a guitar choir, so that's just, I think it only has three solos on top of each other there, so triple solos instead of harmony solos.
Okay, so we're gonna find breathe My Name. There it is. And there's another cool song too called Put Some Mustard On It, which I really like.
Another really positive song. It's a very positive song.
Is
Put Some Mustard On It and Breathe My Name. They're Wicked Twin love songs. All the love songs are about my wife.
Aw, hey Christina. We're gonna say hi. Hold on a second. I've got here's Breathe My Name, My Wicked Twin.
What's that you say? Can you come away?
98.5 CKWR, my wicked twin, breathe my name. Brent, you know what? It's been so much fun having you as a guest. What's next for my wicked twin?
Nine more singles from the Nobody, I'm Nobody Approved, right?
Yes.
So I called the album Nobody Approved. There's a song on there called I'm Nobody Approved. Indie Tunes Records suggested to me not to release an album all at once because only people only listen to the first or second song and skip the whole rest of the album. He says, I suggest you release one song at a time as a single every time, and you'll get more traction that way. There's a tip for all you musicians out there thinking of releasing an album. Put them out one single at a time. You'll get more traction.
Well, you know what? And where can people find you? You're on Facebook and all
yeah,
that?
Yeah, Facebook, My Wicked Twin, YouTube, My Wicked Twin. You can follow IndieTunes.com, IndieTunes with a Z, T-U-N-Z.com. Our songs are there. And, you know, Spotify, all the usual places, you know.
Thank you so much. I want to say a huge thanks to my very special guest, Brent Derner, being my guest on Coral Rocks this week. Coming up, Fangirl Frequency with your host, Cora Cool. Stay tuned. 98.5 CKWR. I'm going out for a double espresso.
Listening to 98.5 CKWR, Waterloo Region's adult alternative.